He put his life on the line for his country. Now his government says he is not entitled to a piece of plastic with his picture on it. An 88-year-old local veteran struggled to get a photo ID. Now, we learned about this story just before the requirement for Pennsylvania voters to show photo ID at the polls was struck down.
Yeah, but as Action News investigator Bofta Imam tells us, that doesn't mean you don't need that ID, Bofta.
Exactly. A photo ID allows you to open a bank account or even board a plane. It's especially important when the state asks you to give up your license because of a medical condition. That's what happened with the veteran we spoke to. He surrendered his license, but then PennDOT refused to give him a photo ID.
There's a big battle wagon, honey.
Ed Churby says these photos taken decades ago capture his duty to serve.
There's a lot of guys that ever didn't come home, but our ship did.
The World War II veteran sailed on this ship, the Stanton, helping land troops around the world, risking his life.
I was over when the Tommy bomb was dropped.
But the same country Churby once served recently refused to provide him a photo ID.
It kind of made me feel down and out.
They ignored his military documents and this notification of birth registration dated 1925 that he's used as his birth certificate. The document even served as his ID to join the Navy, but it wasn't good enough here at the Driver License Center.
I wanted to reach out to other people also, kind of a buyer beware, because they had told us ages 70 and up it would be so easy. Well, we've been there 3 times. We also visited a state representative, and she wasn't able to get any definitive answers for us.
That's why Churby's granddaughter called Action News. We reached out to PennDOT for answers.
PennDOT says they can't talk about specific cases, but says the notification of birth registration was a document they've never seen before.
With an atypical document, it is up to PennDOT to review the document and verify the document. Now, sometimes that can't happen very quickly.
Should the Uniontown Center have reached out to the state office to double check?
It's a shared responsibility. The customer comes in with a document, and then we do play a role in verifying that that document is correct.
I just hope they get it straightened out, because it's very disappointing to me.
Now, the state says they don't track the number of people who are refused a photo ID. We try to get some of those numbers.
Doesn't it just break your heart? You want to just grab them and give them a big hug, but I know you, and I know you probably got meddling in this.
We got some meddling, if you want to call it. We have good news to share. Within a day of our calls to PennDOT, take a look. This is what happened.
Finally got my card.
We're happy now.
I'm grateful for that. I appreciate you, Channel 4.
Aww. Still some good news there. They went to the same center 3 or 4 times. Can you believe
really?
That? Trying to get these answers. So, most importantly, Churby's family says PennDOT really apologized to them for what they had to go through. Driver and Vehicle Services says a notification of birth registration for other folks out there is accepted as proof of citizenship for anyone else who might be going through this. So,
aww, I think it's a good story and you solved a problem.
Well, we helped at least one person. So,
well done.
And they offered you dinner.
Yes, Churby did offer us dinner. I'll let them know now they're watching that you want to come too, and apparently so
We're
does
coming.
Mike. That's the whole Channel 14.
Both. Thank you so much. All right.